You might remember the 350 Legend test that I did a while back with Winchester Deer Season XP. That was a less efficient bullet. It was the same weight, but it was in that little 350 Legend rather than big old 308 that we have here today. That made quite a mess in the gel. It made a huge hole, just big devastation. That's the kind of thing that would liquefy a deer's innards. This is the 308 version, so we're going to find out how it does today. First, let's get a little accuracy testing and see what kind of velocities we're dealing with. We're going to see how precise this is overall. Again, don't worry too much about how it prints on the paper. If it groups up nicely, that's fine. It might do the same for your rifle, it might not. There are just differences in barrel lengths and barrel construction that may change how your gun actually reacts to it. So you have to test it for yourself. But one thing that we can all look at is the velocities. They should remain pretty consistent between us. So if this is good, consistent ammunition, you should see good, consistent velocities. Oh, that was a little left. I felt that. I pulled it. And yeah, the group opened up just a little left. Vertical is still looking really good. So that was my fault. Keep that in mind. That one felt good. Oh, wow. That one dropped quite a bit. Came down left. All right, something went screwy with round number three. It did go down and left, and for some reason my chronograph didn't pick it up either. So we're gonna have to grab another round and try it again. That felt good. Okay, that's kind of curving up and to the right just a little bit. That felt good too. And that one dropped down and right, 2,845 feet per second. So that's just tracking right in there with those other ones. Okay, that one felt just slightly left when I pulled the trigger. Oh, and it threw another error. All right, I guess I need to fix where my chronograph is, but let's take a look at the numbers. Okay, so for those four shots, we have an average speed of 2,860 feet per second. Extreme spread of almost 100 feet per second, standard deviation of velocity of 45.42, that's really high. Okay, so not the most consistent, and you can see that it did get some flyers out there, but definitely minute of meat. This is something that would work on a deer. All right, let's go put one of these through the gel. If this is anything like that 350 Legend round, I'm gonna be working really hard to clean the gel after this. That one might have come in just a tad low. So I'll put another one right above it. Okay, yeah, good position. Shot number one came in low. It made a nice pattern. It's three-dimensional. It has just a lot of little spurs coming off it. But you can see that it dove down here and it actually bounced off the table. And here we find the jacket of the bullet. Just kind of sitting under the block. It looks like it bounced off the table, hit the gel block, and then just kind of stayed there. And then we have chunks of lead going back, and there is what's left of the core. Both of those are pretty good sized chunks. It was a 150 grain bullet to begin with, and I'll bet we have at least 100 between these two parts. So pretty good for a non-bonded bullet. You can see that it did come apart, but actually check out this other one. This one is great. This one's probably more indicative of what you're after. This track is our Deer Season XP. There's the tip that sheared off. And you can see that there's actually not all that much that peeled off the bullet. Even though this is not bonded construction, I can see a chunk of lead there. I can see some little chunks running back through here, but for the most part, it's actually pretty clean.
And remember that just like the other tests that we've done, this is 20% gel. This is not 10%. This is to simulate deer flesh, and this is going to put up a bigger fight against the bullet than some of the others, like the 10% that I've shot before. This has a huge wound channel that begins about 1 inch in. This is the one that opened up the quickest. And this permanent wound channel, I'm gonna say that it cuts pretty much back to about 14 inches. So this is just huge. This is going to cause a whole lot of damage. And you can see that it ended up almost exactly at the same depth as the Nosler AccuBond above it. But the big question is, will this have the same retained weight? Before we leave this track though, let's take a look at its width. At its maximum width, this is about 1¾ inches all the way across. So that's going to put it in pretty much the same territory as the AccuBond. Very impressive performance for really kind of budget ammo that you can find on your Walmart shelves. It's astounding to me that this Deer Season XP performed almost as well as that AccuBond bullet. This is also about 3/4 inch across, just a little bit bigger across that face. And you can see that we have these petals all peeled back very nicely. Everything's held together. I don't feel any rattling. It doesn't feel like the core wants to come out of the cup. But let's see what kind of weight we have. Remember with that AccuBond, we still had about 140 grains of that initial 150. So let's see how this did. Okay, so there's the difference between the Deer Season XP, which is cup and core, and the AccuBond, which is designed to hold together really well. 116.4 grains left. If that's a big deal to you, go for the AccuBond or the Terminal Ascent. But this performed really, really well in the gel, so I have no complaints whatsoever. Now make sure that you like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell down below, because we're going to be testing this round for its external ballistics. We're going to put this through an AR-10, and we're going to see how it performs on target from 200 meters out to 500 meters. Don't miss those tests. They're going to be really exciting. I'll see you all around.
Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the Destructive Arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.